Welcome, Weirdos. I'm Darren Marlar, and this is Weird Darkness. Will the world end soon? Do the pyramids of Egypt predict our upcoming demise on September 23rd? Does the Bible point to this specific date as the beginning of the apocalypse? Some will call these predictions heresy or madness. Others, however, are not so quick to dismiss them. In this episode, authors Billy Hallowell and Rob Waugh give us separate opinions so you can make up your own mind. If you're new to Weird Darkness, here you'll find ghost stories, unsolved mysteries, and other stories of the strange and bizarre. I'm always looking for both fiction and nonfiction stories of the paranormal, strange, supernatural, dark, and creepy. You can even send me links to articles, creepypastas, and other stories you find online that you feel would be great for the show, which is exactly what happened with this episode. Share all of your ideas with me at WeirdDarkness.com. Music in this episode is provided by Shadows Symphony. You can find them online at facebook.com/shadowssymphony. Now, sit back, turn down the lights, and come with me into the Weird Darkness. Will the world end on September 23rd? Here's the complete story on the latest Armageddon claim, written by Billy Hallowell for Faithwire. There have been quite a few murmurs and even fears among some cohorts over an impending date, September 23rd. Why, you ask? Well, some believe the day will usher in events of great prophetic significance. It's become such a prevalent topic in some circles that Answers in Genesis, a Christian ministry, decided to address it in a blog post earlier this year, explaining what exactly is sparking so much interest in what would generally be deemed a regular Saturday. Quote, "On this date, the sun will be in the constellation Virgo, the Virgin, along with the moon near Virgo's feet. Additionally, Jupiter will be in Virgo, while the planets Venus, Mars, and Mercury will be above and to the right of Virgo in the constellation Leo," unquote, Answers in Genesis explained. Some people claim that this is a very rare event, alleged only once in 7,000 years, and that it is supposedly a fulfillment of a sign in Revelation chapter 12. Before we continue, perhaps it's prudent to look at Revelation 12 to see what language, if any, might lead people to assume that there's some sort of end times connection to this celestial happening. A quick look at the chapter does reveal some interesting text. "A great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and a crown of 12 stars on her head. She was pregnant and cried out in pain as she was about to give birth. Then another sign appeared in heaven, an enormous red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns on its heads. Its tail swept a third of the stars out of the sky and flung them to the earth." With all of this in mind, the central claim is that the alignment of the constellations, sun and moon, will somehow be a celestial representation of what's described in Revelation chapter 12. Creation.com recently tackled this issue and skeptically questioned why so many people find the need to try and tie specific and definitive events with prophecy and the biblical end times. The website cited Matthew 24, verse 36, a verse that reads, "But concerning that day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but the Father only," and said the following. So what would the woman be? Apparently Virgo, the Virgin, the second largest constellation by area in the sky after Hydra. However, there is no historical relation between the constellation and the Virgin Mary or any other biblical woman until the Middle Ages. Long before that time, the Greeks and Romans mostly identified the constellation with Demeter, Ceres, the goddess of harvest. Other candidates include the Roman virgin goddess of justice, Justitia, or the Greek virgin goddess of purity, Astraea. So there is no indication that the writer of Revelation had this constellation in mind. So we don't agree with gospel-in-the-stars ideas for that reason. also because of its implicit denial of the sufficiency of Scripture. The above should be enough to exercise proper biblical discernment, but what about other claims? First, the Sun will be in Virgo. But since Virgo is part of the zodiac, this happens once per year by definition. The Sun spends about a month in each of the 12 signs. The zodiac is the sky around the ecliptic, the apparent path the Sun traces in the sky, or under the correct geokinetic model, the plane of the Earth's orbit around the Sun. Another supposed sign is the Moon at the feet of Virgo. But since the Moon orbits the Earth once per month, and the Sun stays a month in each, it's not surprising that one or two days every year both the Sun and Moon will be in Virgo. Both Answers in Genesis and Creation.com conclude that likely nothing is slated to happen on September 23rd, and that biblical prophecy, in the eyes of those ministries, isn't likely to come to fruition on that day. Christians need to be careful about being drawn into such sensationalist claims, Creation.com warned. And Christopher Graney, writing for EarthSky, noted that the woman clothed with the sun with the moon at her feet is just as common in September as is Labor Day, due in part to the Earth's orbit, so this arrangement isn't